Functional residual capacity is a crucial concept in the field of respiratory physiology, representing the volume of air that remains in the lungs after a normal quiet exhalation. Unlike the volume of air expelled during a forced exhalation, the FRC is what keeps the lungs partially inflated during regular breathing cycles. This video covers the medical definition and provides a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. FRC is essentially the sum of the expiratory reserve volume and the residual volume. The expiratory reserve volume is the additional air that can be forcefully expelled following a normal exhalation, while the residual volume is the air that remains in the lungs even after a maximal exhalation. Therefore, understanding FRC is vital for various reasons. First, because it plays a significant role in the mechanical aspects of breathing. The lungs and the chest wall naturally want to move in opposite directions. The lungs aim to collapse inward, while the chest wall strives to expand outward. The FRC is the equilibrium point at which these two opposing forces are balanced, which means that no additional muscular effort is needed to keep the lungs at this volume. This balance is also essential for maintaining the functional elasticity of the lungs. Second, the FRC serves as a reservoir for oxygen, ensuring a continuous supply of oxygen to the bloodstream, even between breaths. The FRC is therefore integral to maintaining adequate gas exchange, especially during physical activities when the body's demand for oxygen increases. Clinical assessment of FRC can be crucial in diagnosing and managing various respiratory disorders. A decreased FRC may indicate restrictive lung diseases like pulmonary fibrosis, while an increased FRC could be a sign of obstructive diseases like COPD or asthma. The FRC is often measured using techniques like helium dilution or body plethysmography. Additionally, FRC is a valuable parameter to consider during the mechanical ventilation of critically ill patients. An inappropriate FRC can lead to inadequate oxygenation and can also increase the work of breathing, exacerbating the patient's condition. This is why an understanding of FRC is not just theoretically important, but has practical implications in critical care, diagnostics, and treatment planning for respiratory conditions. So, as you can see, the functional residual capacity is a key physiological parameter that serves multiple roles, from acting as a balance point for the mechanical forces acting on the lungs to serving as a reservoir for oxygen. Its assessment is essential for diagnosing a range of respiratory conditions and for the management of mechanically ventilated patients. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.